Hello, everyone, and welcome to Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. I'm your host, Pete Estes. We'll start today's show with a weekly award for women's hockey junior forward Dayna Colang, who was named the Hockey East Warrior Player of the Week. Colang scored 4 goals in 2 Catamount games this weekend, including a hat trick on Sunday, continuing a 4-game goal-scoring streak. Vermont players have only recorded 4 hat tricks in Division I play since 2001, and Colang has done it twice this season. During last weekend's men's basketball game at Hartford, America East rolled out part one of a reunion feature on the 2004-2005 squad that went on to upset Syracuse in the NCAA tournament. Here's a brief clip of the first segment.
It was a long time before we got good. You know, I mean, we got where we were okay, 16 wins, 14 wins. You know, we were there, we were close. But when these guys came in, they just won. They won from the minute they got here until the minute they left. It was just unbelievable.
Conrad finishes it off with the jam.
You just couldn't get any different, more different, separate group of guys. But when you got on the court, it just meshed. Everybody knew their role. Everybody knew their job. You know who the stars were. You knew who the others were. And that's just how it went.
And everyone, you know, on the team kind of picked that up and understood, you know, this is about a team. And if we do well as a team, you know, we are all doing well.
We were a unique group. I think that's why we're here now. I mean, it had us. A special bond, and we kind of, the community took to us, and yeah, this big lumbery guy from West Barnett, just, you know, and they just, we were like the odd couple, this kid from the city, we talk funny. And
I think my nickname was the babyface assassin at one point during
he couldn't grow fit any face, all this facial hair, not he wasn't, he didn't have any of that for a couple years.
I got these two young whippersnappers. I said the one guy never talks and the other guy talks all the time, but you can't understand him. But I think they're going to make it together, and they really did.
Part 2 will air on ESPN3 at halftime of Saturday night's men's basketball game at Stony Brook. Switching gears now, Daniel Giron, who just wrapped up his senior season for the men's soccer program, was called up to the Guatemalan U23 national team. We caught up with Daniel and Coach Cormier to talk about the opportunity.
It began when I was 20 and I was in junior college. And I played U20 over there, but I didn't really get the opportunity to really prove myself in team. Just a couple days ago, I just got the call and said, they just pretty much said that I was invited to the camp. It's the beginning of everything, so, you know, there's a good opportunity to go and prove myself, try to get a spot.
As a youngster, he was on the radar, and, you know, and I think over the last couple weeks, months, you know, they've sort of picked up their interest, and they've had some conversations with him. And recently, I think they've looked at footage of the season, and they've seen some of the things he was doing for us. You know, I think it could be an asset for them.
I mean, everybody wants to play for their country. I have the opportunity because it's a pretty small country, so, you know, they try to see everybody. They can't play, so, I mean, it's a dream to play for them. Hopefully, I can get a spot there and actually play in some big games.
It's sort of a kid's dream, you know, to represent your country, and I know he takes a lot of pride. You know, being from Guatemala, and you know, when they made the invitation, I think it's very exciting for him and for us. I think he's made great progress as a player this whole season. He's made, you know, towards the end of the season, I thought he's one of the best players in the field. So, yeah, he's in a good spot, and we're proud of him.
To the slopes now, a pair of former Catamount National champions will be skiing in the 2015 FIS Alpine World Championships in Vail, Colorado over the next 2 weeks. Tim Kelly and Jonathan Nordbotten will be competing in the slalom races out west. Kelly, the 2011 NCAA slalom champion and 3-time All-American, is representing the U.S. and Redneck Racing. Nordbotten, meanwhile, the 2013 NCAA giant slalom champion and 5-time All-American at Vermont, will ski for his native Norway. Moe's moment of the week time, we told you about it earlier, and here's Dayna Colang's hat trick against Providence.
Ducks the shoulder behind the net, comes to the back end, centers it out in front, top of the crease, they score! Right circle, Zubak, Willard, fires, save, rebound, score! Dayna Colang has a hat trick and the Catamounts lead 4-1!
That's all for us today on Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. Plenty more next week right here on Catamount TV.